Hello, welcome to Arbind Singh Academy and myself Arbind Kumar Singh. We are discussing paper of IIT JEE Advanced, paper 1, section 2. We are going to discuss. I hope you have already watched part 1, that is section 1. And now this is an integer type question we are going to discuss today. Try to understand and enjoy the solutions, way of solving the questions. For those students who are going to prepare for next year, they will be definitely benefited this time. So try to understand, and if there is any confusion, do write to us on our Gmail ID arvindsinghacademy@gmail.com, or you can contact us via Facebook. Our page is ASA, so you can contact with the Facebook as well. Now we are going to start with the questions. Let us understand the solutions, right? So the first question, this section is five question. This section has five question, and these five questions are single digit integers from 0 to 9. For each correct response, you will get 3 marks, but if there is a wrong answer, then in that case, you will be able to get 0. There is no negative marking. So this is somehow good news for you, but here is a question. That sides of a triangle are sides of right angle triangle are in arithmetic progression. If I draw a triangle and if I say here that this is a right angle triangle, right, and there is a the side of this is in AP, so I can assume it like I can assume it one side is A minus D, right? Other side is A, and the third side must be A plus D. This is the hypotenuse. Opposite to right angle definitely would be hypotenuse. So that will be ABC, a right angle triangle, and this would be hypotenuse. The area of triangle is 24. This is given. What given is? Area of triangle is 24. So solution can be written like, since area of triangle is 24, so that is 1 by 2 into base into height is 24. So I can say this implies A into A minus D is equal to 48. That would be one equation. Now, moreover, if I would write here that this is going to be arithmetic progression, and these are two sides of right angle triangle, so we know by Pythagoras theorem that hypotenuse square, by using Pythagoras theorem, what we have, A plus D whole square is equal to A square plus A minus D whole square. Hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. That will come up like A square plus 2AD plus D square. I am writing here A square plus A square minus 2AD plus D square. So obviously that D and D cancels out. This A square cancels out. So A square minus 4AD, that will come, and which is equal to 0. That implies A square is equal to 4AD, or A is not equal to 0, and therefore we can say A is equal to 4D. This is the second equation. Now, since A is equal to 4D and we have calculated the first part, so why not I can put A is equal to 4D in second? So if I using this fact, we can write here from first A is equal to 4D, and this is 4D minus D is equal to 48. That means 4D into 3D is equal to 48. 12D square is equal to 48. This implies D square is equal to 4, and D must be equal to plus minus 2. So if I put value of D is plus minus 2, then what will come? Value of A will be accordingly will come, and A will be 4D. So in that case, A will be what? A will be 4 to the 8D. But negative sign we can avoid because A cannot be negative. So we will reject the negative sign. Reject the negative sign. We reject the negative sign. Negative value. Negative value. Right now. And therefore D is equal to 2. And correspondingly if I put here A is equal to 4D. So A must be equal to 8. A must be equal to 8. And therefore sides of triangles are, sides are A minus D, 8 minus 2, that is 6, 8 and 8 plus 2, 10. These are three sides of triangle. So what is the length of smallest sides? And therefore length of smallest side is 6. Smallest side is 6. This is what we have to calculate. So length of smallest side is 66. That we have to calculate. So now consider the next question. And what about this next question? Find how many values of P for which this coordinate axis have exactly three common point. Clearly, this is a equation of circle x square plus y square plus 2x plus 4y minus P is equal to 0. Clearly, here g is what? Coefficient of minus half of coefficient of x, that is 1. G is half of coefficient of x and minus g is a center. So, f is half of coefficient of y, that is 2. So, center is minus g minus f and that will give, what is that? Minus 1 minus 2. It means center of circle lies in third quadrant. And radius would be, what will be radius? Radius will be considered as, radius will be under root g square plus f square minus c. And c is what? C is nothing else but this is minus p. So center will be something g square plus f square minus c. How many values of p that they will cut three common points in coordinate axis, it means they must intersect either coordinate axis at 3 point and because it is a circle, so they cannot intersect the circle coordinate axis at three distinct points. What they can do is either they can touch the circle, either if they touch one of them like x axis or y axis, or they can intersect the other axis. So this is a possibility. So I can write here that taking into consideration that this will intersect either x axis. So what will happen is it can touch x axis and intersect y axis. This is a possibility. Either they can touch x axis and intersect y axis. So this is a possibility if it touch x axis, because center is lies here only, minus 1 minus 2, this is the center, you know, and center coordinate says C. If it touches x axis, this is x axis, this is y axis, and if it touch A at B, A and B are 2 points where they intersect, and at C, C I have already used, so I can write this as O, center is at O. O is a center and they intersect A at A and B. In that case, the condition of tangency for x axis, the condition of tangency, a circle which touch x axis, if x square, the condition of tangency of x axis is what? GSC is equal to G square. This is the condition of tangency. Or x intercept is 0. X intercept must be equal to 0. So C is equal to G square and condition of tangency of y axis. The condition of tangency of y axis. Condition of tangency of y axis is C is equal to F square, right? These are the two conditions and C is equal to F square and C is equal to G square, because X intercept is what? x intercept is, as x intercept is what, 2 under root g square minus c, and that will be 0, and this implies c is equal to g square. And x and y intercept is also like y intercept will be 2 under root y axis, that will give 2 under root f square minus c is equal to 0, and that will give c is equal to f square. So first case I can consider that either, let this is a case first, I can consider this is a case first where they touch x axis and intersect y axis at two distinct point. So y intercept must be positive, greater than 0, and x intercept must be equal to 0. So here c must be equal to g square, that is minus p must be equal to what is g? 1 minus p. Therefore, since first case, when circle intersect y axis and touch x axis, in that case y intercept must be positive, 2 under root f square minus c must be greater than 0, and g square is equal to c. These are the two conditions. Here in place of c there is minus p, so I can write here minus p, c is equal to minus p, and what is g? G is 1, so p is equal to minus 1, p is equal to minus 1, and c f square minus c is greater than 0, and that will give f is what? 4, and this is p, p is greater than 4, and therefore p is greater than minus 4. So p must be greater than minus 4, and p is equal to minus 1. So is it valid? Yes. Is it valid? Minus 4 is, p is greater than minus 4 and p is equal to minus 1. Since minus 1 is greater than minus 4, and therefore from first and second we can have, solution p is equal to minus 1. First solution A, I can say. The second case we can consider here, that when they touch x axis, y axis and intersect x axis. Case 2, I can consider here, when circle touches y axis and intersect x axis, when touches y axis and intersect x axis, in that case what will happen? In that case, like this would be the case here, if I can write here, and this is a case where a circle can touch y axis and intersect x axis. Yes, this is the way where circle touches x axis and intersect at y axis. Say again, this is A, B and C. Touches A, B, and this point of intersection is C, and center is minus 1, minus 2, that is considered as O. So x intercept must be greater than 0. Therefore, x intercept is positive, that is greater than 0. Means g square minus c is greater than 0, means g is 1 square minus of p is greater than 0, that is p is greater than minus 1. And second, y intercept must be equal to 0, that is f square is equal to c, and this implies 4 must be equal to what? C is minus p, so p must be equal to minus 4. P greater than minus 1 and P is equal to minus 4. minus 4 is not greater than minus 1. Minus 4 is less than minus 1. So therefore, in that case, there is no solution. No solution. Right? Case third. When we can say, what will be the case third? Case third, whether they touches x-axis, passes through origin and intersect at two points, x-axis and y-axis. It passes through origin and intersect x-axis and y-axis. So in that case, what will happen? If a circle passes through origin, if circle will pass through origin, will pass through origin. In that case, it will intersect x-axis at once and y-axis at once, right? It will intersect x-axis at once and y-axis at once. In that case, what will be the solution? So, this x-intercept and y-intercept both will be positive in that case. X-intercept as well as y-intercept both will be positive, right? So, that will be here, circle will be like this. Circle will be like this, and it will intersect x-axis. This is A, this is B, and this is C. So, x-intercept also positive. Therefore, x-intercept also positive is greater than 0. That is, G square is greater than C. That is, 1 square is greater than minus p. 1 is greater than minus p. 1 is greater than minus p. That means p is what? P is less than, p is greater than minus 1. P is greater than minus 1. Right? Multiply by negative sign. Sign of inequality will change. So, p is greater than minus 1. Second, f square is greater than c, that this employee f square is greater than c, that will also give f square minus c is greater than 0, that will give 4 is greater than minus p, or 4 plus p is greater than 0. Even you can write here, it will be better to write 4 plus p is greater than 0, because c is minus p is greater than 0. So p must be greater than minus 4. So, this is the second condition. P is greater than minus 4 and P is greater than 0. But here, P is what? Must be equal to 0. Because any equation which is passes through origin, C must be equal to 0. This is the condition. Although these have been discussed separately, but here no use of all this. But 0 is already greater than minus 1 and minus 4. So, both the conditions are satisfied. Just to clear the concept and develop the idea, I have given this. Otherwise, one can write it directly that P is equal to 0 if circle passes through origin. Then P is equal to 0 and P is equal to minus 1, there are two values. So, for this equation, there will be two values, two solutions. Overall, how many solutions? Two solutions. So, number of solution is 2. Answer will be 2. Right? I hope you got it. Now, the third question is what? Third question. During the examination, no need to write all this because it will be lengthy. But even then, my motive is not to discuss and develop the ideas that how to solve the questions quickly. But my purpose is to develop the concept in which a student will be able to understand. And fast method is used here. But even then, I'm not writing each and every step so that it will take some time to solve the question. Here, linear equation has infinitely many solutions. In matrix method, even you understand that if determinant of A is not equal to 0, this is in form of AX plus B. This determinant is matrix is written as AX plus B in form. So, if A is not equal to 0, then system has unique solution. You know that. System has unique solution, But here what they are asking? They are asking infinitely many solutions. And infinitely many solutions, for infinitely many solutions, determinant must be equal to 0. So for infinitely many solutions, for infinitely many solution, determinant must be equal to 0. And this employ 1 alpha alpha square alpha 1 alpha and alpha square alpha 1 must be equal to 0. If I solve this completely, then what I can take is I can solve by using this property c1 tends to c1 minus c2 and c2 tends to c2 minus c3. So in that case, what we'll get is 1 minus alpha, alpha minus 1, alpha square minus alpha, and alpha minus alpha square, or even I can write here 1 minus alpha and alpha minus 1, alpha square alpha and 1. Keeping all these 1 minus alpha common, so what will happen? 1 minus alpha if I take common, or alpha minus 1 we can take common from both, taking common alpha minus 1 common from c1 and c2, then what will happen? We will get here that alpha square, it will come like alpha square, it will come like alpha minus 1 square, because alpha minus 1 can be taken common from both. So what will happen here? Alpha minus 1 we have taken common, so what is left here? Minus 1 and here 1, and here if I took alpha common, then 1 minus alpha will left, alpha minus 1 will left, so 1 also here alpha will left, and there minus alpha will left, alpha minus 1 if I take common, and here minus 1 left, and there is 1 left, and alpha square alpha and 1. So keeping all these together, we can solve it. So using this, alpha minus 1 whole square into minus 1 into e, this cancel, minus 1 minus alpha. So it will be alpha minus minus 1, and this will be cancels, minus 1 minus alpha. So if I took common minus, then it will be plus, and alpha plus 1 will left. And what is that here? That alpha h, this cancel, 1 minus alpha square, 1 minus alpha square. And the third one is this cancel. So this is 1 minus minus alpha, that is 1 plus alpha. So 1 plus alpha, that will come. And that must be equal to what? 0. So alpha plus 1 can be taken common from this. So alpha minus 1 whole square into alpha plus 1. And what is left here if I took alpha plus 1 common? 1 plus alpha plus alpha plus 1 I have taken common, 1 minus alpha left. And what is left here? 1, that is 0. So in that case, alpha alpha cancel, 1 plus 1 plus 1, 3. So in that case, this will be 3 times of, 3 times of alpha, 3 times of, that will be 3 times of alpha plus 1 and alpha minus 1 whole square is equal to 0. In that case, alpha is 1 and minus 1. But when alpha is equal to 1, what will happen? If I took alpha is equal to 1, in that case, this there is no solution. Why no solutions? Because if I put alpha is equal to 1 from here, you will see that if I put alpha is equal to 1, this will be 1, 1, 1. In that case, if you product this matrix, this will be 1, 1, 1, and x plus y plus z is equal to 1. Again, 1, 1, 1, then x plus y plus z is equal to minus 1. It is not possible that simultaneously x plus y plus z is a 1 and x plus y plus z is equal to minus 1. So alpha is equal to 1 won't give any value. There will be no solution for putting alpha is equal to 1. So now we will put here alpha is equal to minus 1. So alpha is equal to minus 1. When alpha is equal to 1, no solution will be obtained. And so put alpha is equal to minus 1. Now the value of value of 1 plus alpha square is equal to what they are asking. They are asking the value of 1 plus alpha square is equal to, this is what the value they are asking. So 1 plus alpha square, that is 1 plus minus 1 plus minus 1 square. So 1 minus 1 plus 1 is equal to 1. So answer will be 1. In that case, because it will be 1 plus alpha square, that is 1, and minus 1 plus 1, so that will be 1, because this will be cancelled, and that will be the answer of this question. So hopefully you got this idea. Although I am solving it step by step, it will take some time, but don't worry, that my purpose is to give you the exact solution. Understanding will be there. No need to work like this, that what is the answer, because here I want to solve for those learners who are going to appear in next year, and those who have already given the examination, hardly it will matter for them, but those who are going to appear, a concept is required to develop. So that is why I am discussing like this. Word of 10 letters, word of length 10 are formed by using this 10 alphabets. X be the number of such word where no letter is repeated, and Y is the no letter is repeated. 10 different solution. 10 different person can be arranged in a row in 10 factorial ways. Only 10 different alphabets can be arranged in 10 factorial ways. So 10 factorial, X will be 10 factorial. Now they are asking about Y. Y be the number of some, Y be the number of what they have written, Y be the number of such word where exactly one letter is repeated twice, right? So first we have to select those one letters out of 10 letters. So Y can be considered like this, number of arrangement. First we have to consider one letter out of those 10, that those who will repeat twice. And out of remaining, we need 8 letters out of it. Now we have 10 letters, in which 8 are different and 10 are similar. They can be arranged in how many ways? 10 factorial upon 2 factorial. Why? Because 8 of them are different, so no need to do this. 2 of them are identical, so we need to divide by 2 factorial. Now they are asking about Y by 9X. Then what will happen? 9Y by 9x. So what to do? Y by 9x, if I am going to solve this, what will come? Y by 9x. Now Y by 9x, we have to calculate Y by 9x. So let me write this, first simplify this, and then I'll write Y by 9x. Y by 9x is what? So this can be 10, C1 is 10. 9c8 is also equal to 9c1, and 9c1 is 9, and this will be 10 factorial by 2, 2 factorial is 2, so that will be cancelled by 5. So that will come 45 into 10 factorial. Now y by 9x is what? Y is 45 into 10 factorial divided by 9 into 10 factorial. 10 factorial, 10 factorial cancel, for 9, 5 ja 45. So what will be answer? 5 will be answer in that case, and answer is 5. So that single digit question will have answer 5. So these are few questions. It hang now, and let me discuss this again. Sorry, it will take some time, and thus 5 is answer, right? So let us do the next question. And next question is what? Try to understand. This is in the next question. I would like to see here. The next question is, it is given that R function is R to R be differentiable function such that f 0 is 0 and f of pi by 2 is equal to 3. F dash 0 is equal to 1. If gx is equal to 0 to pi by 2, then this is a function f dash t. And cosec t minus cosec t cot t and ft means this is a derivative of first ft into second function as it is, and this is derivative of cosec t. The product rule is applied here, so we can write and we can take as gx is a function, and what to do with this gx and what to write here, try to understand. Just I am telling here, writing here all these things. Fx, let gx is, gx, since gx is given already, what we'll do, x pi by 2. This is nothing else but derivative of function. What is this? This is d by dt of what? Ft and cosec t. Cosec t. Right? This is a function, derivative of this. So, if differentiation and integrations are, this is the reverse process. You know that. So, once integration of this derivative function, then sign of these two will cancels out. And what will happen? This is ft cosec t, and where to where? Lower limit is x and upper limit is pi by 2. So if I put the value of upper limit, f of pi by 2 cosec pi by 2 minus f of x into cosec x. This is a question. F of pi by 2 is 3 given here in the question, and cosec pi by 2 is 1. Everybody knows this. F of pi by 2 is given, f of pi by 2 is given 3. Here in question, you have seen this, f of pi by 2 is 3 given, and f of, so I can write here, this is 3 and cosec pi by 2 is 1 minus fx, and cosec x will be in denominator and that will be sin x. So this gs function will be 3 minus fx by sin x, right? This is 3 minus fx by sin x. I hope you got it. And now we have to find limit x tends to 0, gx is equal to what? And function is defined between 0 to pi by 2. So there is not a case that this cosec x is not defined. Cosec 0 is not defined, but because it is open interval, 0 is not inclusive, so function is defined. Now we have to find this limit x tends to 0, gx is what? So we will write here, limit x tends to 0, gx is what? So limit x tends to 0, gx is equal to limit x tends to 0, what? 3 minus fx upon sin x. 3 is constant, so no need to write limit here. This will be already outside of the limit. So I can write here 3 is outside and minus limit x tends to 0. If x will be 0, then f 0 is equal to 0. That is given in the question, and sin 0 is 0. So this is in form of 0 by 0. Using L'Hospital rule, we can write here limit x tends to 0, f dash x upon derivative of sin x is cos x. Now, put x is equal to 0, this will be f dash 0 upon cos 0. And f dash 0 is given what? 3 minus 1 upon cos 0 is 1. So that is 3 minus 1, and therefore 2 will be answer of this question. So question answer of this question will be 2, because f dash 0 is 1 given here in the question, and you will be able to analyze this f 0. 1 f dash 0 is equal to 1 given. So in that way, the questions of these integer type has been discussed, and hopefully you got the solution of all these questions and you able to understand all those solutions clearly. And if there is any problem, do write to us at arvindsinghacademy@gmail.com. and if there is any problem, you can also write on and send your queries on our Facebook page, ASA. So Arvind Singh Academy, that will be located on the Facebook. So you can write on our Facebook page, or you can mail us any problem if you have during the submission of any questions. Thank you. Thank you very much. God.